I run a science museum, and I have to say that the state of science education in the United States today is woefully bad. At this point, according to a study that was done by the National Academy of Sciences, this report was called Rising Above the Gathering Storm. We are number 28 in terms of the quality of science education in the world. We are number 47 in terms of the number of the proportion of college graduates who are in the sciences. We're behind Finland, for Pete's sake. Science is very important to our future, to our economy, to job development. The key to success in the world economy, the United States' success in the world economy, is innovation. Innovation fueled by science, innovation fueled by growth, innovation fueled by what we learn in school. And what we learn in school, unfortunately, is not enough. What we learn in school today is from books, from computers, and from the mind. My interest is in informal science education. Imagine, if you will, the yin and yang symbol. The yin is the formal science education. The yang, of course, is informal science education. Informal science education is hands-on, minds-on, solving a real problem, not getting something from a book. That's what a museum does, providing that kind of experience. It can happen in schools too, and there are many wonderful people who are working hard to bring science to folks, but it's not happening. The problem really is in two areas. One is in the way science is taught, and I spoke to you about the lack of informal science education in the schools. The other is that we are not organized as a community to teach science effectively. It does take a village. It does take a village to develop an interest and a love for science. It takes support. It takes a whole community working together to make this happen. How do we get our arms around this problem? As a nation, it is so important to us. China has replaced the United States as the number one technology exporter. More U.S. patents were achieved by non-U.S. companies in the United States than U.S. companies got patents here. Of the 10 most important, most lucrative, best jobs, according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics, fields like information technology, advanced materials processing, biotechnology, nanotechnology, all the ologies you hear about, of those jobs, 8 out of the 10 require involvement and understanding of science, technology, engineering, and math, the so-called STEM fields. So the question is, as a community, not just as a nation, but let's start with a community, how do we get our arms around this problem? How do we see a situation where we're working off a common agenda, cooperating on our activities, and developing programs that engage hearts and minds and produce results? There is one place where it's happening. That's in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Carnegie Science Institute has formed an institute for STEM technology. It has the support of companies like PPG, Chevron. It has a major government grant. It has support from local companies and businesses, social service agencies, everybody who should be a part of the solution to bringing science to the level it should be in our country. We can do that here. All of the pieces are in place. There are many organizations, many individuals who are working effectively to teach science to our kids. But they're working in silos here. They're doing their own thing, diligently and effectively for them. But it's not happening as a collective. That's what we need to have here. We need to create a collective opportunity. Just suppose, for example, that we were to take all of the science fairs that are going on in our community, and there are hundreds of them in just this community. And if we were to organize them like it was March Madness, 64 teams, a whole series of playoffs, a Final Four, money, prizes, lionizing the winners, lionizing the parents of the winners, providing support, exhibiting the winning projects in a museum, for example. What a shot in the arm that would be for science and for kids to get excited. What a shot in the arm that would be. There are many other projects. Hooking up kids who win an essay contest with the orbiting International Space Station. A conversation with an astronaut while he or she is up rotating above the Earth, 160 miles above. These are the kinds of things that we need to do together. No one of us can do this individually, or at least we can't be effective at it. So my call to action is this. On May 27th, at the South Florida Science Museum, which is on Southern Boulevard, located just off I-95, I will have one of the leading foundations in Florida. I will have the school district. I will have a member of a leading social services agency. I have a business development board person. I will have all of the pieces in place that are needed to develop the bandwagon effect for science education in our community. I want you to be a part of that. I want you to come, or to come in spirit. As you leave today, or maybe it'll be right after this, I'm not quite sure of the logistics, you'll be given a card. And if you support the need for better science education in our kids, if you support the need for our country to be more effective and more competitive in a globally changing world, then you will pick up that card and you will say, I want to help. This is your opportunity. This is your opportunity to make a difference and to help all of us in our area be effective. That's a result that we can produce together. We can make a start. Our museum can make a start. We've got the right people at the beginning, but there is so much more to be done. Help us, and the rewards will be very great. Thank you very much for your time and attention.